CDNN is proud to give you a late night with Old Man. On tonight's episode, we have two of the guys that brought to us the Dogcraft Hunger Games, alien sightings, and much, much more.
Welcome to the Late Night Series, brought directly to you from the Dogcraft server. Now, some of you may be wondering, something is odd. Well, as you might be saying, it's nice, it's different, it's unusual. Well, to those of you out there, I have one thing to say to you. Look out, we're shaking things up. With the recent departure of William 278 from the team, we're now going to focus a lot more on community, and as such, try and get many of you, that's right, our loyal viewers, to help us out. We'll be focusing on interviews from key individuals, tours of towns and bases, and of course, following up on all the recent events and happenings on the Dogcraft server. Now, let's get started. First up on Dogcraft, we've recently had the first Survival 4 Dogcraft Hunger Games. But before they actually happened, we had an interview with Elliot the Red and Montanator. So, let's play that clip.
Well, here we are with Elliot the Red and Montanator. Coming up in a few days' time is the very first Dogcraft Hunger Games. Tell me, guys, what prompted you to put this event together?
I'll take this one.
Yeah, you should take this one. You came up with it.
So one of the builders who's not currently interviewing with us, Lazy9, had come up with an idea. We had been wanting to sort of make an event for a little while, me and him. And then back in mid-June, he was like, oh, it would be cool to make a Hunger Games arena. And I was like, that's a lot of work. That'll take so long. And I was just like, we committed to it. And then we brought in a couple of other people like Montanator and N1C. And we kind of just committed to the idea of just making a Hunger Games event because we thought it would be cool to kind of have our own event that we organized and built. And, you know, we thought that it'd be a fun thing that a lot of the community members would be excited for.
Exactly, that's the main payback, just making people happy.
Yeah, and that's it, isn't it? All about the events, making people happy. And, like, how long have you guys been planning this for?
Oh, it's a good 2 months now, probably approaching 2 months.
Probably at the time of the event happening, it'll have been 2 months since we, like, first started, like, placed the first block of construction.
Yep, and so I think you guys have been going for a couple of weeks before I joined, and then Nick joined another week later.
Yeah. Because you were there after the wall was already done.
Yeah, but it's been a long time in the planning, so it's good to see it finally done.
I bet you're very excited about it coming up.
Yeah.
Well, it shows some true dedication anyway. As for the event itself, can you explain to me and the viewers the different areas of the map and why those themes were chosen?
Yeah, so we've got four different themes, distinct themes around the map. You've got the space area, which is kind of open. It's quite good for open PvP. The graveyard's a lot more enclosed, lots of more stuff going on. And you've got yourself the Candylands as well, and the western area. So all very distinct zones of the map. And then you've got the cornucopia in the center where most of the chests are, and that's kind of the center of all the action.
Wow. So tell me, who's the one that likes the candy, one of the candy zone?
I'm looking at you, Elliot.
That reminded me, the candy zone was an idea. Funny enough, an old Dogcraft member, Pyrax, if any of you guys remember him from old Survival, we used to actually go on servers with him, and he was creating this new server that he like hosted himself, and he asked me and Lazy9 to build a Hunger Games map years ago. And we had an idea for an entire Candyland area. So my choosing the Candyland area as like the area that I wanted to build. Now it wasn't just me, obviously, that built it. Everybody pitched in. But choosing the Candyland area as like a theme that I wanted to be in the map was kind of a tribute to the old server that he had, and like the old Hunger Games map that we never ended up finishing.
Oh, that was nice.
But it was in creative. It wasn't in survival, so it was a lot easier. But we just didn't really get around to it, you know.
Excellent. Cool. So loot boxes, hey, they must have taken some time to put together.
How much
I'm looking at you, Monty.
We have 300 loot boxes, and that's not even including the ones that we'll have at the cornucopia. So I've spent the past week basically in the same area for the whole time I've been on the server, just sorting out the loot boxes. But there's three different tiers, each with varying degrees of like weapons. For example, tier one's wooden tools and leather armor, and then it gets better in tier two, and then tier three is even better than that. But it's taken a long time, but it's finally just about done. So, oh, that's a good news.
Oh, wow. So there's a lot of thought into this game. How exactly is it going to work?
So we'll start out with the contestants that have signed up through the announcement, and they will all start out in the cornucopia, and we have a piston activator so that you click a lever, somebody who's organizing it clicks a lever, and all the pistons will kind of go up, and then you'll be able to get out of your arena through jumping. As if the pistons are down, it'll be like multiple blocks, you wouldn't be able to. But then, sorry, I'm over-explaining it, but you'll get out of the event slot or the starting slots, and then you'll be able to run around the map and just loot chests, and or you can stay in the cornucopia and try and fend off people there. There will be a 1 minute grace period to start, so that nobody dies right, so that people have time to get away or at least loot a couple of chests first.
Yep.
Exactly.
There are a couple of other various rules, like there is no teaming to help keep it fair, that people don't get ganged up on in the event, and making it kind of fair for people who may be worse at PvP who don't get double teamed or anything like that.
I mean, the beauty of the event,
just kind of loot chests and just walk around.
Yeah.
And, you know,
well, see, the thing about the event is that there's lots of different play styles you can use. You can be very aggressive and you can go for the kill points, or you can be very passive and then try and play for placement points. It does cater to people that aren't as good at PvP as well as people that are quite experienced in PvP.
Yeah. And yeah, we're using a point-based system to determine the winner after three rounds of playing. You get a point for every five placements that you are up, and you also get extra points for being for finishing first, second, or third. And then you get a point for every kill you have. So, you know, you can always hide out and try and get that podium spot to get extra points.
Exactly.
Very aggressive and kind of kill a lot of people at the start, but then peter out and only maybe get 20th place.
Yeah, it should make for lots of interesting scenarios, so it should be pretty cool.
Awesome. Awesome work, guys. So, I can't wait to see the event come to life. With anything else you guys want to say? Any comments?
I mean, not really, I think. Well, unless you've got anything, Elliot.
I would just say it'll be a great event. Hope everybody has fun. And
May the odds ever be in your favor.
May the odds ever
be as they say.
True that.
As they say.
Well, guys, with the miracle of editing, let's fade out and check out the event.
Woo!
Right, five.
I've got my pants.
Three,
ready.
Two, one, and go, go, go.
Bloodbath. I'm watching kill feed.
Whoops.
All fajita. Oh, this might be the final battle.
Oh my god.
Don't worry, I'm sorry, I'm just console.
Well, there certainly is some strange stuff happening on the server lately, from DC debugs to strange disappearances. We've actually had some footage sent to us. Now, before you see it, let's just remember, don't go all out. Some things are unfounded and based on rumors, and as such, should not be trusted. So, let's roll that footage.
I was just minding my own business. Then all of a sudden, this alien UFO appeared. I don't know what they want, but they sure have a nice UFO.
There are aliens amongst us! If you see any, make sure to take a photo and send it in. Anyway. Okay, now, on to other news. Recently the server was updated to 1.16.1. And as such, a brand spanking shiny new Nether. Let's check out how our interdimensional correspondent, Rai, handles it. Oh, look, it seems like he's having a party for the exploration send-off. I hope he has his trusty handheld cam so we can ride along. Wow, that new Nether sure does look inviting. But now it might come to a surprise to you all, but our events crew have been hard at work building us a fantastic Halloween event to enjoy later this year. Earlier today, I tried to get a sneak peek of some of the building happening over there. So, be quiet and let's go check it out.
Excuse me, sir. What are you doing over there? What are you doing here?
Sorry, yeah, just sort of get some sneak peeks of the event that you guys are building. You know, show the viewers, get them excited.
Yeah. I mean, this area is kind of off limits to the public at the moment, but if you must look at something, look at this warp mushroom over here. It's fascinating, really.
Wow, that really is fascinating. But hey, what's over there behind you?
Where?
Haha, sucker!
Well, that certainly didn't go according to plan. Oh well. Now that just about wraps up this episode. But before we go, we want to remind you, don't forget to subscribe, so you can keep track of everything that's happening on the Dogcraft server. And if you've seen anything you like, comment below. But enough for now, I'll leave you with our last episode star comment. Bye for now. Thank you.